have come all the way from India, right here to Pennsylvania to try and win PennApps this time.
PennApps is a student hackathon. It was the world's first student-run college hackathon, and we've been at it since 2009.
A hackathon is where a bunch of designers, like computer science people, maybe graphics, get together and they build something cool and innovative.
I mean, you come and within 2 days, you have to form a team and you have to come up with an idea and you have to build something that works and you show it.
PennApps is 36 hours long, so people get in Friday evening and they have till Sunday morning to take whatever they can find around them on the internet, in our hardware labs from our sponsors, and turn it into a real thing that works and does something hopefully useful.
You can actually pull off something like a mobile app or even a hardware hack or something like that in 2 days.
But we've had an incredible amount of support from Penn Engineering and our title sponsor Comcast. Both of them played an absolutely pivotal role in making the transition from Penn Engineering to the Wells Fargo Center possible, and we're incredibly thankful to both of them for that.
Well, probably if we win this, you see the next billion-dollar company coming up.
We are so excited to have you guys here. Are you guys excited to be here? This amazing hackathon. I call this the Super Bowl of technology. I want to wish you the best of luck and happy hacking in the days to come. Thank you.
We're working on a food delivery service app, kind of like an Uber X if Postmates was Uber.
The video records two screens side by side, and we had to line up the cameras, which is why there's this crazy doodad. And so then we get stereoscopic vision by having them slightly left and slightly right. And then what we do is we're gonna splice it together in here so that you get left vision, right vision, and then it's three-dimensional, and then that's pretty cool.
What I'm trying to do with the glasses is to interface them with these sensors and sync them with music.
The hardware lab here is awesome. It's my first time using Oculus, my first time using Leap, and they even 3D print stuff. That's like really, really crazy. It's amazing.
So we're at the PennApps hardware lab, and we've got actually a subset of the AdLab 3D printers have been moved here. PennApps participants are 3D printing all sorts of different parts that they're using with their hardware hacks, and we can help them design those 3D printed parts, or they can just bring us their designs, and they're made right here.
Well, this is going to extract what it's actually saying. So this will be like provide blah, 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 blah. Okay. Right now, it's, oh my God, it's 4:40 in the morning. We're making government forms more accessible, basically. So we're very, very close to our web tool being done.
It's currently 8:42 a.m. We have probably 10 minutes to wrap this up. It's been quite an experience. I've never seen my own alpha waves before, but I'm pretty sure I have this weekend.
Already it's 9 a.m.
Submit.
And so we just integrated the
and for this hackathon, we built a virtual reality mini golf. Then we built this hardware gadget right here.
Hey guys, we're Fifth Sense. We're from Carnegie Mellon. We've created an assistive device meant to assist the visually impaired in day-to-day tasks.
When text is being sent to the device, you'll feel it in the form of a vibration. Braille is sent in the form of 6 bits, and for each bump that you'd normally see in a raised text, you'll feel a vibration.
Now in first place, made the trip worthwhile. Fifth Sense.
Hopefully in the future, we're able to continue to do what we're doing right now, being able to maintain our quality while getting more and more people into the space where we can expose them to the technology industry and just the builder industry, really.